and thanks for watching Cooking with John. And today I'm going to talk about bananas. And to start this off, we're going to talk about peeling a banana. So we all know that we normally start at this end, but did you know, and some of you probably already have known, that monkeys start from this end. So all you have to do is just twist this bottom part here, and it's a little bit tougher on some of the green ones, but it's still very easy to peel the banana this way. Of course, if you're like me, I don't like this brown thing on the end, because if I peel it for the other way, I always end up leaving this part, because for some reason, this little thing, don't like it. But for some of you other people, it's probably not such a big deal. But I'm a picky eater at times. My mother will vouch for that at any time of the day or evening. So we're going to do a recipe that I like, and it's called banana flambé, and it's actually very simple and very easy. And all you have to do is get your bananas, your brown sugar, grand marnier, and butter, and mix them all together, and it comes out with a unique flavor, and add ice cream with that. So we're going to start with, and I already have put it in the pan, the recipe is such as this: 6 ripe bananas, 4 tablespoons of butter, 2 tablespoons of sugar, 1 teaspoon of cinnamon, and 1/4 cup of rum. Now I'm cutting this down because I'm only going to do 1 banana. Don't need to do 6 because I'm not going to eat all that. So I've already melted the butter and put the brown sugar in and the cinnamon, and as soon as it started to melt, mix that up, get it going. And as soon as it warms back up, then we take our bananas lengthwise, put those in here. Sorry about that. Thought I had everything together. And we're going to get this nice and crispy. And this is where the flame comes in. And that's not me. So, the flame, you're going to put the rum in here, and then you're going to ignite this. And of course, you want to be back because the flame is kind of big because it's off the fumes. So you don't want little kids looking over at this to see this. So if you got guests who want to see it, tell them to just kind of stand away, because when I light this thing, you're going to see what I mean. So we get that going in there. And all you have to do is tilt it a little bit. And of course, it's not doing it for me. Oh my God. I've been doing this. I have been doing this recipe for so long. That is the first time that it's never ignited. So maybe I didn't have it hot enough. And being an Italian, oh, you know, a little bit of extra alcohol doesn't hurt anybody. Tell my grandmother to put us to sleep. So let's try this again. Well. Okay, just pretend that the light. Okay, you know, I can't redo this and start all over. I could, but I'm not going to. Basically, there would have been a big flame coming off of this, which would have been nice because it burns off the alcohol and leaves the flavor back, but I guess these are going to be a little bit more potent than normal. That would have made a thing. A nice blue flame. That would have been about this high. I'm going to flip this over. Oh, well, it'll give everybody something to talk about. And it doesn't take very long to cook these. They do pretty good fast. Now, since some people don't like bananas, I thought I'd try something a little bit different and add some blueberries. Since I'm now kind of much into eating a lot of fruit now in my diet, and I actually like blueberries, and they do add a nice purple color to this. Get that going in there. And this is really beginning to smell really good. I can smell that grand marnier and the caramelization of the sugars. So I normally would have been done by now if I wasn't fussing to try to get you a flame, which is probably a good thing because I probably would have burned the house down. So, we're done with that. And as you can see, these are pretty long bananas. I would probably cut these in half. Get the ice cream out. Oh, this smells really good. I thought I was really quick at this. And have it all nicely prepared for you. One more thing. And then once you put the ice cream onto your dessert plate, then you sprinkle a little bit of cinnamon on that, and they say you can also put sugar, but I think there's enough sugar on here. I tend to put a little bit more of the juices because now you're going to get more of the blueberry. And if you didn't put anything else on there, then this is going to be a banana flambé without the flambé. So you don't really need to have it anyway, but this could be your dessert after a lovely dinner that you have made for your friends. So I hope this was informational for you. Sorry about not getting the flame, but I'm sure my friends are going to tell me I'm the biggest flame, and that's enough anyway. So anyway, I hope this recipe is really good. It's very simple. Again, it's just butter, brown sugar, cinnamon, and fruit, and Grand Marnier, and then you light it. Well, normally it does light up. So have a good day, and I'll see you guys later. Bye, and thanks for watching Cooking with John.